Aren't you troubled by multinationals and the size of companies? And that's not what Adam Smith meant. Adam Smith didn't mean for Exxon to have a 60 and 70% profit.
Of course I'm troubled by multinationals, in the sense that I would rather have a world in which there were a larger number of small companies. The question at issue is not that. The question is, what are your alternatives and how do you promote such a world? One of the major reasons you have multinationals and large companies now is precisely because of the role which government plays. Here is Chrysler. Get back to it. The chairman of Chrysler is spending full time, has hired a whole group of lobbyists in Washington. He is engaging in a political campaign to get the government to bail him out. Mm-hmm. Now, is that a productive use of effort? If he weren't doing that, if he isn't bailed out, will the effect be that Chrysler will disappear? Not at all. Most bankrupt companies come back into operation with a new management and a clean financial slate and are more efficient. The fact that Chrysler goes bankrupt doesn't mean that his factories are going to go up in smoke. If they're worth using, they'll be bought by other people to be used.
Like GM?
And in fact, you'll have a strong... They might be.
Doesn't that bother you?
As compared with what? As compared to have the government own the factory and produce it?
Can Sears buy Kmart too in your room?
Of course.
You think so?
Sears has been one of the great protectors of the consumer all during its existence. As a matter of fact, you say, can Sears buy Kmart? The way Kmart has been growing, the question is going to be, can Kmart buy Sears?
Yeah.
But aren't you troubled by multinationals and the size of companies? And that's not what Adam Smith meant. Adam Smith didn't mean for Exxon to have a 60 and 70% profit.
Of course I'm troubled by multinationals. In the sense, I would rather have a world in which there were a larger number of small companies. The question at issue is not...